And welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. I'm your host, That Guy. Let's get cracking. If I'm correct, we should be up to 13, I think. About 13. So, we're about to possibly meet up with Sundowner, the protector of the brains. Yeah, I know. And look, they're arbitrary. Here's more health for you before you enter the boss battle. Sundowner, is he a hard boss? First time, maybe. Oh shit, no, it's not Sundowner. That's Mistral, actually. But here's the thing.
What? Mistral?
She's.
No?
A spear body, if I had to guess. Likely controlled by an AI.
They made extra bodies. We're just dodging like crazy here. There's nothing actually here to dodge either. It's a weird part. So, we'll see if you have more fireball attacks. Yeah. At the same time, every time you destroy a tripod, it gives you. Oh, up. It gives you help. So. Oh, fuck. One thing I just realized as well is that. Oops. Yeah. I haven't actually used the. Problem is that you can't merge the attacks together. So, even though there are attacks which use Y. You can't link them with X, which is kind of annoying, really, because you can't do staff attack to sword attack. So I can't do that. I'm safe, even though I did it very cool. Let it rip. Where are you? That's right, she picks them up and then chucks them at you. Okay, so that's how she gets one. I'm back! That one's really cool. Just for the sake of the carry one. She always just dashes up to be like an absolute crazy button. Like, fuck. The problem is, keeping my eye on Mistral too much, I really don't need to! Maybe then we'll do it appropriate time. Yeah. Everything gets destroyed. Everything. Oh. Knock down. Oh, damn it. Oh. Fuck. You can actually see her throwing it at me as well. That's a good part. She gets more arms back, and maybe like a pole arm stance. Oh, probably a bit far away. Got a bit. Shit, my boss! Oh, no, you don't. I don't know why she's not gonna very well. It might be easier to just fly attack. She's nearly done anyway. Come on, there we go. Oh, I'm getting tired of getting better. Okay. That's Mistral done. Guess who else? This is the attack I didn't get to show you guys before.
Terrible soup? Well, if it's AI controlled, it should pose no problem for you, yes?
Don't bother trying to fight through the space. He only pops up for a second and really can't do much about it. I need the EM grenade. Let her rip. No, this is the worst place to be against a wall when this happens. Can't see shit. Damn it. There we go. Fuck you. Can't even tell his head, really. Oh, no. Parry it up. Parry it down. Timing. Come on, come on. I gotta say, it's a lot of fun fighting him, but you don't want to parry this bloody much. Oops. No, shit. Sorry, I have to actually scratch my face then. Not doing that attack on me. Shit. It's bad enough that that you jumped out of the screen. I couldn't even see what attack it was doing. And we're against the wall as well. This is the worst place to fight him. Make it easier. Yeah. Oh. Parried way too early now. Shit, we need a grade. There we go. Chomp! Stop. Oh shit. Crap, I didn't really didn't want to use a help on it. It really makes a difference. It's relatively easy. Get this part down. Granted, it is just a lot of random attacks though, so. Trying to kill a lot. And score? Wait, C. B, alright, that's fine. Can't Zandatsu them, Zandatsu them. Unfortunately, so, yeah. And this is
don't
their
disrupt the students while class is in session. I believe you're familiar with the lesson plan. The same regimen you went through in Liberia. Effective program. Just look how you turned out. Of course, running it in the real world just got a bit too complicated.
Damn that beacon.
Virtually, though, no fuss, no muss. Straight to the brain. It's like a dream. Well, maybe dream is the wrong word. They do kill some POWs, some civilians. They enjoy it, though. We give their pleasure centers a nice big jolt every time. Plus, they get a shiny new body as a graduation present. Another thing you have in common. I chose this. They're kids, you son of a bitch. And kids are cruel. All people are by nature. They just lose touch with it as they get older. Start thinking they know right and wrong. That's immoral. War crime this, code of conduct that. Kids, you can mold. Manipulate into performing all kinds of atrocities. And there's nothing like a good atrocity to keep a war going. That's why I'm shutting you down. You just don't see the bigger picture, do you? Say you bring this whole place down. Waltz out of the rubble with all these precious brains. Nothing changes. All the guys in charge are long gone. We've got offices around the world. We're just suppliers. We don't create the market for war. And who does? The Patriots are gone. Those guys just managed the war economy. They didn't invent it. Did you think every battle in history was all part of some big old conspiracy? Bullshit! War is just part of who we are. Why fight it? Anyway, none of this will matter in 3 hours. Demand for PMCs is about to skyrocket. Like the good old days after 9/11. What are you talking about? Not here. Follow me.
Raiden, get Sundowner. Do not lose him this time.
Oh, sorry, I just realized that my microphone wasn't on. There is an item here. Obviously to prepare for the boss battle. And anything on the other side? I think there is. Could be. Let's check anyway. It's an interesting concept that Sundowner has presented. But in general, it looks like that's the only thing up here. See anything else to happen, so. Let's go after him. Coming around. That's right there. And this gamut doesn't help me. In case you guys are watching it and it looks fine to you, I actually am playing in a pretty well-lit room, so I can't see half the stuff that you guys can see. Which, if you've watched me doing my playthrough of Syndicate, you'll know what I mean. Like, I had a lot of problems setting that up. Actually, I don't know if that's in there. Never mind. Anyway. Just for the sake of it, I'm just going to get rid of this.
How's this, Jack? We can play up here without damaging the merchandise. What happens in 3 hours? Don't matter. You're too late. Even at Mach 2, you wouldn't make it. And killing you is gonna take some time. Slow and painful.
So Sundowner's got a few interesting tricks. Firstly, those plates are explosive, so if you hit him while... I usually carry them. If you hit him while... Okay, see how the thing is shot there? You have to hit along there. If you hit anywhere else, boom, it just blows up.
Keep your blade away from that shield.
And you can't really do anything about the helicopter. So basically just find the right lineup and chop. And then it will show you which plates you can chop off. Hello. Oh fuck. What am I thinking there? Jesus. Back.
Hey,
which way is it? This way. That way. Oops. Shit. I think it's out. Doesn't matter, we're just damaging some more. Never mind. Does a lot of damage for a character like this. There you go. It also happens vertically. We haven't seen any of this already, but you can place it vertically if you really want. Damn it! It's hard to see when you're obviously attacking like shit, huh? Damn it! I can't believe I did it again. There we go. Raiden, I don't think we should be standing there. Oh shit, that's the... yeah. Usually he's really easy for me to beat. And he doesn't even get to use many attacks. I've already damaged him so much last round. Nice uppercut, buddy. Let's get used to parrying him. Like, he telegraphs his attacks fairly long. Cool. I'm gonna put that launch me as well. Oh, really? You want me to get some health back up? Thank you. Oh shit, no, that's not my idea. Same room to get the freaking pole out of nowhere. It's okay. This is meant to happen. Just have a spear glider. A slider, as they call it. You do have guns while you're in this mode, so, like, rockets, firing them. Just need to watch the outfit debris. It's very strange, I think somebody can do a flying section in this mission, so you have a boss fight for it. And if you're wondering why I'm shifting left and right, I can't see anything. Chop the roof up. And be very careful about this QTE because there's really not much time there. poor guy. I love seeing that.
Attaboy, Jack.
What happens in 3 hours?
He'll launch Operation Tecumseh.
Who? Armstrong?
I've already said too much. I have a call to make.
Got yourself shaving?
Get your wish.
Raiden here. I've taken Marshal HQ.
Yeah. I have just entered Denver airspace. I will be there soon.
Hurry.
Raiden, what Sundowner said?
I know. Anything that'll rival 9/11 cannot be good.
And in 3 hours, maybe less. He said even Mach 2 could not get there in time.
If he was serious, that's over 4,000 miles away.
4,500. So whatever it is, it's not happening on American soil.
If it's gonna spike demand for PMCs, it's gotta be a political hotspot. A coup or civil war in a stable region wouldn't have a domino effect.
And they'd want to draw in a superpower. No.
What?
The president. He's on his way to Pakistan. If something happens to him there...
Oh, shit. The War on Terror Part 2.
Contact the military.
Official channels are frozen since Mexico. Unofficial channels would take too long.
Besides, what's our proof? Who's gonna believe us over World Marshal?
Then we have to get there first.
Nevezmuzhna! Impossible! It is the other side of the planet. Even if we were in the world's fastest jet right now, it's not even close.
Hold up. It's not a jet we need.
Courtney?
An RLV would make it with time to spare.
That's...
Mach 23, if we're talking one atmosphere. 17,650 miles per hour.
That would make Pakistan in under half an hour.
Right. Contact Solus.
Yep, we're gonna take a really fast way to get there, huh? I need a B, which looks about right, actually. And we can now dress up as a desperado. And we get pincer blades! As usual, I don't actually use the side weapons much. You would have already noticed that by now. I'm just gonna do some quick customization, and then we'll finish the video as soon as we can. Actually, first, let's get the blade. These do a ton of damage. It's kind of insane how much damage they do, actually. Oh, I can't afford it. I think there's some skills that actually use the pincer blades. Yeah, it's like big, fucking heavy damage attack. So. Upgrade. So, yeah, it's going to cost a lot to upgrade them anyway, but, and also, the new body if you want, but it doesn't do anything, it's literally the same as the other one, color texturing, basically. So, yeah, no point in really getting it. And with our new, unique weapon, obviously, we can, buy enhancements to strength up, but, what's the point, it already does enough damage, huh? Okay, man, this is gonna take a while, isn't it? Gotta watch the opening video.
Cargo's all set to go, sir.
Excellent. Commencing takeoff in semi-auto mode. This kind of space launch once required days of preparation.
Solus has been conducting test flights almost every day for the last 6 months. As long as we're not breaking atmosphere, they said they can reroute today's flight no problem.
Amazing! The Earth is the cradle of humanity, but mankind cannot stay in the cradle forever.
I'm only going as far as the thermosphere. This thing can't pass the Kármán line. That lunar vacation will just have to wait.
And here I was hoping you might bring me back a monolith. Scheiße! Two bogies closing fast!
Is it?
Who else? The flight pattern suggests unmanned MQ-320s.
Shit.
This is a transport chopper. Our defensive options are limited. Missiles incoming!
EMP?
Yes, but not strong enough to take out the drone. nice flight.
And people say Germans aren't funny.
Chopper around.
Sorry, my friend. Your sacrifice will not be forgotten.
That was quite the fall, Raiden. I'm glad to see that you are all right. Hmm? It's time you got out of Denver.
Damn right. Right, so we're gonna finish this video here because we are way, way over time. As well as this free simultaneous boss fights, repeated boss fights. So, we'll finish up here. So, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And as per usual, take care of yourself out there, yeah?